An illness outbreak forced at least 120 students to miss class at Ray St. Pierre Academy in Marrero this week. Crews deep cleaned and disinfected the classrooms. Spending time in close quarters like classrooms or offices can make it easy to get sick or catch a virus. And Touro's family medicine physician, Dr. Meredith Maxwell, shares some tips on staying healthy. Good morning.
Good morning.
All right, let's start with work first, since we spend so much time there. What are your thoughts about how do you stay healthy at work?
Well, definitely you need to clean your surfaces and be careful about whose surface you use. So if you use somebody's computer really quickly, you might want to wipe it down before you actually use it. Telephones too, you don't really think about that, but viruses can live on surfaces for as long as 2 hours, maybe more sometimes. So you really need to be aware of kind of surfaces, desks, phones.
Just stand up.
Yes.
Like, you know, this. All right, you know, in terms of sanitizers, you know, you don't have soap and water necessarily
right.
Every moment. I've heard that sanitizers are good. They're not a substitute for soap and water, but what are your thoughts?
So you need to get enough alcohol in the sanitizer that you're using, greater than 60% alcohol, which can be really drying on the hands, by the way. But you really need to rub it in. You need to rub until it's completely rubbed in, and that's very important. And as for the soap and water, you need to do it long enough as well. Happy birthday twice. While you're washing your hands,
your ABCs.
Yeah, yes. Yeah, sing your happy birthday twice. It's a good way to teach
kids.
What
was that alcohol level?
60%.
60%
or higher.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
If you mentioned something when we were talking before we went on about water can help you. Water can help you. Prevent you from getting sick?
Well, your body being at suboptimal levels can have, you know, a way for a virus to sneak in. So making sure you get enough sleep, making sure you're not skipping meals, making sure that you, you know, drink enough water. Those are all things that can help you kind of get your body in tip-top shape.
You know, you send your kids off to school. We heard the story about the school that had the problem. I mean, is it just a crapshoot, or is there anything you can do?
It's super difficult. I mean, you really need to get your kids all your vaccinations. That's so, so important. Protect your kids as much as you can. Really teach them not to drink out of other kids' bottles and waters and sharing food, especially, you know, during high viral illness season. That's, I think, a good thing to teach parents.
You know, Nancy jokes that her parents were both educators. She had to be practically on her deathbed before she got to stay home from school. And I understand, you know, it's a child care issue, but at what point do you say, okay, you know, stay home?
So any weird rashes, vomiting, diarrhea, a temp of 100 or greater, you want to keep your kid at home, because you are just going to, that one kid can spread it to the whole school, as we have seen.
Or get sicker, and then you have the bigger
exactly,
issue.
And then just keep rotating it as well. So it's really important to try and keep your kid at home.
All right. Dr. Meredith Maxwell. Thanks. She was like having an appointment for free right at home. 7:18. Here's Shelby Latino.
Also the daughter of teachers and also had to go to school on my deathbed. I think I had to be throwing up before they would check me out. My mom's probably watching this and saying, quit telling all those people that.